Once upon a time in the good old United Kingdom, it was the norm to have a job for life and have a guaranteed income each month. Sounds good, right? Well, after the 2008 financial crisis, a little contract popped up, the zero-hour contract, with nearly 700,000 people employed on them. So what does it mean to work under a zero-hour contract? Do you have any employment rights? And would you be supported through mentally and financially dark times? These are the questions I wanted to answer.
Worked on a zero-hour contract for 7 years. I stayed with the company for a few reasons. One, because I'm a loyal person. Two, because I felt kind of trapped. I kept sending off my CVs to all these different places and it was just getting me nowhere. I had like 2 interviews, maybe 3 interviews in like 7 years. It just made me feel a bit worthless, just like, where's my life going? I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere in this company. And I was never offered the opportunity to. If they had offered me, maybe I would have taken it. My friend used to joke with me saying that I used to do 12 hours a week, which in essence is kind of true, because a lot of the weeks it was like 12, 16, 18. And I did ask for more and I didn't get it. It's probably because there's a lot of favouritism.
To find out more about zero-hour contracts, Mike met Bill from Trade Union Congress to see what their official stance is regarding the issue.
Our problem with zero-hour contracts is people sat at home waiting for the phone to ring exclusively from one employer who might need them for a few hours one day and not the next. We don't think that's right, and we think they should be outlawed.
I know someone who complained that they were getting no hours. They didn't like that person, so they dropped their hours completely and just got rid of them that way, because they had no other choice but to just leave the job because they were getting no hours at all.
Just having someone exclusively at your beck and call is destroying all the employment rights that people have ever had in this country. So, you know, they are at the beck and call. They're subject to hire and fire on a daily basis. They've got no employment rights whatsoever, and that can't be right.
On his way to university, Mike bumped into Lizzie. She's from Unite, an organisation that represents the people. Here's what she has to say about zero-hour contracts.
I know about times when you're happy to have a bit of casual work. No problem with that, none at all, because people who do need flexibility, of course that will work for them. But what employers are actually doing is using zero-hour contracts so that nobody has a proper full-time job with a permanent contract with employment rights, which we are all entitled to in law. For example, your annual holiday leave, your sick leave, your compassionate leave, and things like that. So that what in fact big employers are doing is using it because they save vast amounts of money and increase their profits and obviously alter the unemployment figures. People are having to have 3 jobs, never see their children, you know, nobody can afford childcare. It's an appalling situation.
After having spoken to Liz, Mike wanted to call his friend Jenny, a girl he used to work with. She's a single parent, so he wanted to find out how she copes under a zero-hour contract.
I'm really, really struggling. As I said, I don't know what I'm doing from 1 week to the next, so my wage is very high. So being a single mum and raising a child and working part-time, it's really hard on a zero-hour contract. Not even spending £20 a week on food. I'm left with 75p a week to live on. Running a house on a week-to-week basis is pretty much impossible. I do have ongoing health issues, so work has to be understanding. I have had time off recently, but I wasn't supported or helped through that time.
I'm sure, just from the people I've met, that, you know, if you can't guarantee how much you've got coming in every week, you're worried about buying your food, paying your rent, what you're going to do for the kids. You know, so it's bound to affect people's mental health.
I moved to Reading because my girlfriend died and I just wanted a complete different new life. I just wanted to get away. It was just eating me up, because we used to work together and the customers always used to ask me, oh, how was your girlfriend? Not knowing that she had died, and it was just getting to me. So my brother said that he was moving. He moved to Reading
and I moved with him. The company itself, they gave me a week or two condolency pay, and what's that? It's nothing really. I took in a sick note and from a doctor saying that I was really anxious, depressed, and they just said that, oh, you have to sign on for incapacity benefit, we're not going to do anything for you.
Now that I was in Reading, I was working more hours, but I was working these awful working patterns and I just felt drained and ill all the time. I never had any money after paying all my bills, so I just felt even more depressed. I decided to give up and just return to my old life, back at my mum's.
I just wanted a whole new life, and I came back again. It was just like, well, customers were saying to me, oh, he's back. Oh, I thought you were moving to Reading. And I was just like, well, I don't particularly want to be here, but I've got no other choice. I felt I was back to square one with nothing going for me.
Now studying at university, Mike has escaped that situation for now to pursue a life in filmmaking. Bill left us with what he thought should be done about zero-hour contracts.
It's a bad one all the way around. And I think the TUC have said, you know, that these contracts must be eliminated by legislation as soon as possible.
So we've just had the general election. What do you think is going to happen to zero-hour contracts now?
Well, from looking at the growth of zero-hour contracts over the last 5 years, it looks like they're only going to rise, and it frightens me to think how many more people's lives will become trapped under what I can only view as modern-day slavery.